This is an award I recently got. Actually, no, it's James's. James, you want to come out?
Yeah.
Play the video.
Standing stunt coordination for a drama series, limited series, or movie.
The Emmy goes to Marvel's Luke Cage!
First one was a magician, and second one was like a stunt actor, basically the same thing, more or less, and obviously you've done the latter. So I guess I'm curious in terms of how did you get into stunt acting in the first place? What really inspired you?
Okay. First, thank you for staying. It's been a long day for you guys, and I really appreciate that. When I first started, because I came from a martial art background, and they had a big cattle call for the original Kung Fu series. And me and my buddy said, hey, let's go check that out. Stood in line, might have been 100 people in line. So we said, oh, we have nothing to do anyway. So we got in, and they chose about, I think about 10 or 12 people out of that. So we end up doing all the flashback scenes in the Shaolin Temple. It was Shaolin Temple in Burbank, California. But as a Kung Fu practitioner, it was like this cool dream. They put us in the skull cap and we did all the stuff with the disciples doing martial arts in the background. And we're in every episode for the opening, so it was fantastic. Made some money.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Does someone have the clicker? Oh, see? That was it. Just snap it.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, there it is.
Go back. Snap backwards. Okay. So, James, what is going on here? What is this? These aren't on my Facebook wall, you know? I don't have photos of
that one,
this.
Snooki, that was on my own call. It was Halloween. I decided this brag I did. Didn't have anything else, so I said, that's when Jersey Shore was popular, and I said, I'm going to go be Snooki. And
Hair a little bit?
Oh, that was a little wiggish. But complete respect for the ladies that were dressed, because the party was outside, and it was just freezing. And couldn't find high heels to fit my big feet, so luckily I didn't have to do that. The middle one, I'm very proud of, but talking about selling out, it was a national commercial for Hewlett Packard, and the joke was ordering uniforms for the school, but it was bad technology, so coming back with all these different outfits. So we had, wardrobe came to me with, I don't know if you've ever seen it, the tights are about this big when it's, and they said, we have to get you into it. I have pretty big thighs. It took two wardrobe people just squeezing this thing onto me. But we had fun, we had some laughs. That was from a horror movie.
Oh, yeah, it would be terrifying if I like woke up and saw that.
Yeah.
So, okay, let's look. These photos are more of your day-to-day life photos.
Yeah, this is my job. I get to go to work and basically pretend for a living. So I'm very blessed. That's the Kung Fu with Dave Carradine. And down below is an amazing movie, Inception. I was in that room. It was another scene. I'm in the room with just Ken Watanabe, Leonardo, those other two people. So just me and the director. This is my first time I've ever done anything like this, so it's different from being on the set. But part of that too, I want to get the message across that I want to push myself to constantly do things that out of my comfort zone, and this is not in my comfort zone, but it's all about trying it and just go ahead and do things.
So what was it like when you first started in Hollywood, being an Asian American stunt actor? Like, what was it really like starting out?
I like to call it as there's challenges starting when I did. I first started out, I wanted to be this action actor because growing up, all I saw was, you know, on TV were Three Stooges, cowboys, and at that time I just didn't think like one day I want to do that until Bruce Lee came around, and that's the game changer. Finally, I said, "Whoa, I could kind of look like someone like that." Not quite; he's just ripped. So that got me on the path, like, maybe I can be an action actor. But I went, got an agent, found out that all the auditions, the parts were the computer nerd, Asian guy, the scientist. You get in there and they say, oh yeah, that was great, but can you do it with an accent? And it was not fun doing that. And then eventually, the Asian bad guys kind of came into being, so that at least a little bit more kind of a fun. You get to be a bad guy, get beat up, and I have to say I've been kind of beat up by everybody in Hollywood. From I work with, just throwing names, Jackie Chan, Jet Li, oh yeah, all these guys, Charlie Sheen's fantastic work with. On the far left, that was the first time I had to shave my head on Tropic Thunder. And we got on the set, and a group of stunt guys are there, and Ben Stiller points me out of all these guys and told the stunt coordinator, I want his head shaved. And it was like, what? Why me?
But you had to do it, and then you liked the love scene.
Well, and he said, you know, pretty much if you don't, you're probably going home soon. If you do, you're going to be here for the run of the show. And this was in beautiful Kauai, where it was just like paradise. So I said, fine, I said, yeah, all right, shave it. But the funny thing is, after a couple of days, I loved it. It was like understanding how to be a monk, and you have this freedom of kind of like all your worldly things are gone. And every day is a bad hair day. It doesn't matter.
You don't need shampoo.
Yeah. So now I recently, last year, I got cast to do a little part on this new series called Warrior. It's a concept Bruce Lee came up with. And they wanted me to play a Sifu, a teacher of that. And it was a flashback scene. And they said, we need you to shave your head. And I said, that's it. Yeah. I'm kind of waiting for an excuse. So I'm kind of keeping that now. I'm going to be, try to be the wise master. And that was a great time with Get Smart with Anne Hathaway, and also with Steve Carell.
Not a funny actor.
Yeah. Nicest actors. Comedy was so fun working with these people.
So, I guess, can you tell us a funny story working with one of these actors? Like, what are they actually like working with? You know, we see them on the big screen, but
yeah,
I want to hear some juicy stories.
Charlie Sheen's one of my favorite people I've worked with. I got to play with him on Hot Shots Part Judah, and it was me in a little cloth thing. He was also wearing this little thing, but he got just yoked out for this thing. I think he had a little help. But the nicest, most straight guy, hardworking, not what you hear about on the news. We had a great time working. After that, maybe 6 months after, I was walking along in Beverly Hills. He happened to be down the street. I hear, hey, I'll take you on right here. Like Charlie Sheen was there. So just wonderful guy. Can't say enough about it.
That's awesome. So this past year, Crazy Rich Asians made a huge splash in Hollywood for being one of the first films in Hollywood to be on the big screen, to be in theaters, to have an all-Asian-American cast,
right,
all-Asian cast, and then previously Joy Luck Club also made a huge splash with that, and wanted to just get your thoughts in terms of how has Hollywood really changed in terms of bringing Asian-Americans into the community?
I am so proud and happy for Crazy Rich Asians. It's, to me, fine. I was born in Escalon, California, which is kind of...
Oh, you were going to say you were born in Singapore.
Oh, man.
That's one of the crazy rich Asians.
Actually, I'm crazy rich. but my parents moved me down before I was 1 year old, down to South Central LA, where I grew up. So being an Asian American, I finally saw a movie that portrayed Asian Americans and blending, going to Asia and having that culture clash and how each side learns something from each other. It's a gift for us. It's finally opened the opportunities, and I can see, she's a trooper. Her voice is gone. She's still,
my voice isn't usually this nasty. I'm not acting.
I don't, tell her it's sexy.
Good job.
So it's a very important breakthrough for opportunities now for Asian Americans. And again, we find that there's finally the male lead is a positive guy. We were talking backstage. My little thing about Joy Luck Club, great movie. The one male good guy in that in the movie was Andrew McCarthy. All the Asian males were not the nice guys, so to me it didn't quite balance it. But here is all Asian cast. And the great thing is the audience here took to it because it was just perfect. A good movie first, a love story. And enough people related to it because it's a great love story that the numbers just blew out there. And as much as difficult as Hollywood is, they are basically a business machine. So they will now look at that and think that, well, we can make money on this kind of a movie. So it opens the door for more projects that Asian Americans can be in. The best thing we can do as an Asian American community is to go support movies like this. I went first day. 3 days later, I took my wife to go, but she couldn't make it the first day, just to make sure we get the numbers on the box office. Just do your little part. If everybody helps like that,
yeah, it makes a difference. Especially for opening weekend and the weekend after.
Yeah.
That's great. Yeah, I think it's really changed in terms of, like you mentioned, like when you were first starting out, people want you to be the nerdy Asian, like that stereotype of an Asian, and then Crazy Rich Asians has really changed that because it's not the smartest kid in school, not the nerdy Asian, not the bad villain, but this like heartthrob couple that everyone aspires to be, and it's like crazy rich and like lavish and whatnot. So, do you think we're going to continue to see more films like this, especially with Crazy Rich Asians, or like what do you think we're going to see with Hollywood films?
Well, the author wrote three books. There's a children's.
So there's two more.
There are greenlit number two. But hopefully we're looking at other things. So the great news, Marvel has also put into development Masters of Kung Fu. So it's, hopefully they cast an Asian guy to play Shang-Chi. But at least half Asian. We'll give them that. I see the little light coming through the door now.
Yeah. What about Asians represented on TV as opposed to movies? So there's Fresh Off the Boat, one example.
Yeah.
Or do we still have a long way to go?
Yeah, TV, there's still some need for a positive person, Asian American. I watched the trailer for that way back. Just the male with the accent and... It's like, I'm not interested in watching it, but I should.
Yeah. So what are your future plans? Like, you got this fancy award that
and
looks like...
This is, I have to say, this is...
It's really heavy to
carry, amazing.
By the way.
And I look at this, too. Look at it as an opportunity. I'm representing American Asians. And what's great about it, I am the first American Asian or Asian stunt coordinator to win an Emmy for stunt coordination. And it is really about not anymore knocking on the door like a nice, polite Asian who need to kick down doors. It's how powerful the Afro-American community came. They demanded to have things. Whenever you see a production, they have a lot of the crew are Afro-American, the cast, and everything is across the board. Out of curiosity, I just went on IMDb, looked up Fresh Off the Boat, see what the crew was. I didn't see any Asians. So I wish they would help support it that way. Not only is it important in front of the camera, but also behind the camera. And that's how we start creating more opportunities to get more people to have more experience, to get better. Hopefully we get into the producing side so we can actually control. And writing is important. So any of your writers out there, please come up with things. And this is the perfect time of day perfect time for us now.
Yeah. So, off stage, what do you do in your free time besides kicking down doors or, yeah.
Well, and that's part of what's great too. I want to encourage everybody. I'm so blessed because what I do, I love. It is already my passion. So when I go to work, and I don't tell my wife this, but I am actually going to go play. It's not at work. I'm there creating action, creating, you know, just magic. And I'm not working at all. I'm just having a good time. So find that passion. Find either it's martial arts, find movies. Go from what your heart tells you. And that's, I mean, it's, you hear it all the time, but you know, life is short. And it really is. It's amazing how fast did last year go for it, but bam.
Yes.
Take 5 of those, 10 of those, suddenly, like, what the heck? So, go for it. Because I can really tell you, I went on my own, I wrote, produced, directed, starred, did catering, did everything on one little movie. And it was the toughest thing I've ever done, but I kept telling myself, you know what, at least I don't want to be on my deathbed and just say that, God, I should have done it. I should have tried. It's much better that you got screwed up and it's like, well, maybe I shouldn't have done that. It's a much better way to feel. So run your life like that. There's no regrets because actually you win by just trying.
So we're going to wrap up today with, I just want one volunteer, aspiring actor or actress, to come on stage.
You're going to do a fight scene with
us. We're going to see James train one person for 30 seconds.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Okay, so... I want to know, like, a lot of these actors and actresses, like, they don't know anything about stunt. What's the very first thing that you teach them?
Safety first, because especially if you work with stunt guys, and even actors need to know, if you're doing a fight scene with Tom Cruise, do not hit Tom Cruise. You'll be, get out of here. So, and part of the choreography, and that's kind of... Also, I'm always trying to relate it to life. We start very slow. I call it Tai Chi speed. And so if I'm going to throw a punch, we walk through it. So I'm just throwing it at this speed. So we do that. And the philosophy is slow is smooth. Smooth is fast. Fast is power. So you progress like this. And kind of take that to kind of everything you do. So you take it in steps. So now he's going to block.
Our volunteer looks a little terrified, by the way.
Oh, what's that?
Our volunteer looks a little intimidated by you, just a little. I'm like standing, I'm sitting very far away from this.
Oh, no. Yeah. All right, so as this punch is coming here, I want you just to step to the side a little bit. It's called getting off the railroad track. So you don't want to stand there and just take the punch. So you're going to move a little bit. But same time, you're going to come put your hand here. It's like saying hello on a telephone or your cell phone. So bring your cell phone up to your right ear. Nice. Perfect. So now, so I'm coming slow-mo. So you're going to step to your left block. Wow. Nice. So now fast, no. Got it. So you start building from that point on. So you'd be punched, be a kick, and things like that. So why don't you throw, let's just start with a simple front kick. So you're going to pretend, you're going to come for my face. Good thing I'm not this tall. So do you have martial art background? That's so stereotype. Okay, perfect. So play and kick. No. So form is very important in filming something because we can always speed things up with the film or post-production. But, and part of what actors, if they're just standing like this, there's nothing we can correct. So that's important. So, and come, and it's kind of telegraphing, so the with the right leg back, so just a front kick, so it's chamber, out, back, and down. So keep it clean like that, so slow first, so right here, out, and back. Yeah, it's great. So if you can do it slow, it's easier to do it fast. Okay, so first I'm going to do this slow, punch, block, I come back, he's going to kick at me. So I'm going to step to the side and come back. Cool.
This looks like straight out of a movie. Let's give a round of applause for our volunteer and
So if you guys are interested in doing things like that, everybody has a phone. Get your buddies together, shoot it, edit, post it on YouTube. You never know. It could go viral and you're the guy we're looking for. And girls, women, ladies.
Thank you again.
Oh, one thing. To help me feel a little more comfortable, to feel like this is a, what you call like a dojo, a koan. If everybody can stand up, you want to stretch your legs anyway. This is how we do a sign of respect. It would be the fist, it would be right fist. This hand covers the fist. That's coming in respect. And a bow. And always keep your eyes on the And then, I want everybody to give me a warrior cry, like, yeah, one, two, three. Get a selfie?
I knew it.
Oh no, I'm not good at selfies.
Francis is good at selfies. Francis is the selfie master.
Yeah. Why don't you just do a photo? I have photos assigned for free. Don't charge me. Here we go.
Cry?
Oh, we have to bring
do our stance.
Yeah, come here.
Everybody stand up.
Yeah.